I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball, and that's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Babylon Has Fallen. I'm Mason Sandoval, and today I'm going to be doing something a little different on this episode, and that's being positive. I just saw Zack Snyder's Army of the Dead, and it's a good movie. Like, it's a good fucking movie.
There'll be time enough to count when the deal is done.
This is probably the best zombie movie I've seen since the first Zombieland. I loved this movie. Whole new respect for Zack Snyder. Whole new respect for Dave Bautista, especially. Can we cast this man as Bane, folks? Can we please cast this man as Bane? Dave Bautista's a fucking monster in this. He plays a survivor of an incident that happened in Las Vegas. The zombie outbreak happened, and it was just complete pandemonium. The military got wiped out. They had to quarantine the city. And as a result, the president decides that he's going to exterminate the remaining zombie population by detonating a nuclear bomb. Like a low-grade one, but a nuclear bomb big enough to level the city of Las Vegas. But there's a catch, folks. Dave Bautista gets approached to by this Japanese businessman type, basically saying like, hey, we got like 4 days before they drop this nuke. There's 20 million in a safe. You get your cut. Hire whoever you need to do to get this job done, but we want that money. I know you kind of want that money. Are we doing this or not? They do it. Zaniness ensues. So much fucking fun. Hear me now. If you're not having fun by these opening credits, folks.
Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
If you're not having fun by then, this movie's probably not for you. This movie's not so much scary, it's very, very violent. And if you don't like violence, well, for one, are you really an American? If you do like violence, this movie is so much fun. Zack Snyder directs action, I would say, better than anybody else in the industry right now. There's no fucking shaky cam. You can like legibly see every single like takedown with the knife, every bullet that's being shot, like everything is just very, very cohesive. There are some parts of the movie that feel like they drag on, namely with Dave Bautista trying to reconnect with his daughter. It's a little shoehorned into a movie that's already got a lot going on. This movie is half zombie apocalypse, half heist movie set in Las Vegas. That's an amazing premise. And then you add in like a father trying to reconnect with his daughter. The thing is with that is that you have to take into account the fact that the director is, you know, a father that has lost a child. So with that context in mind, I can't really lop any criticism at that aspect of the film without being a fucking asshole. So, you know, for what it is, I think it probably could have been better if they hired a better actress to play Dave Bautista's daughter. But Dave Bautista himself sells it. He sells every single scene that he's in. In a film that's just so balls to the wall. I mean, they have a zombie fucking tiger, and that sounds stupid, but it isn't. It's fucking amazing. It was like one of the leftover Siegfried and Roy tiger. It's just you need to watch it. It's just great. The supporting cast themselves are actually pretty good. Some stand out a little bit more than others. There's a helicopter pilot who is just a lot of fun, like a genuine a lot of fun. There are a couple people on the team that are badass, but that's kind of all their character. But you know, the thing about a zombie movie, are you really coming for the people? I'm genuinely curious, like, are you watching a zombie movie genuinely hoping that everyone survives, or do you want to see some people die? Now, that sounds very sociopathic, and it is, but there are some parts where it is trying to do a bit much. Zack Snyder expands on like the zombie lore in a very, very creative way. I will say, in terms of the zombies living in Las Vegas, have a little bit of, in the words of Jordan Peterson, a dominant hierarchy. I don't know why I made Jordan Peterson Indian. I'm sorry. No, but there is kind of like a hierarchy of power within the zombie civilization. They have like a full-on civilization. I thought that was interesting, but sometimes it does kind of deter from the actual plot itself. I think my only gripe with the film, I could nitpick, sure, but my only like genuine gripe is the zombie apocalypse stuff is amazing, and the heist stuff itself is great, but the heist itself does kind of get, or feel like it gets overshadowed by a lot of the zombie apocalyptic stuff that we see on screen. Now, the writing in this film has its, you know, iffy moments, but for the most part, I would say it's a better script than we usually get in a Zack Snyder film. Watch it immediately. It's on Netflix. It's only 2.5 hours, which after watching the Snyder cut, is just a walk in the park. I promise my next review will not be on a Zack Snyder movie, but I do sincerely want to say that whole new respect for Zack Snyder. Solid 9 out of 10. I loved this movie. I hope that you do too. Welcome to Babylon Has Fallen. Goodbye.